Have you ever really thought about how a pay raise changes what you toss in your shopping cart? It might seem random, but it's not. There's a whole economic story hidden in our everyday purchases, and that's exactly what we're going to unpack right now. So let's just get right to it. What really happens to your shopping list when you start making more money? Do you just buy more of everything, or is something a little more interesting, a little more complex going on with your choices? All right, to figure this out, let's break it down with a super simple real-world scenario. And it all starts with something most of us can relate to, that morning cup of coffee. So picture this. Your monthly income is, say, 5,000 shekels. You've got your routine down, and part of that routine is buying one specific box of coffee every month. It's a staple. Simple enough, right?
But then, boom, you get a raise. Great news. The next time you walk down that coffee aisle, you've got a decision to make. And, as it turns out, economists say there are really only three predictable paths you're going to take.
The first, and honestly, the most common reaction is pretty straightforward. You've got more money in your pocket, so you buy more stuff. Now, in economics, this has a name. It's called a normal good. And it's simply any product that you find yourself buying more of as your income goes up. It's the most intuitive reaction, and it's what pretty much every business hopes for.
The thinking here is super simple. Hey, my income went up. I can afford more of this. So instead of grabbing that one box of coffee, you grab two. Maybe you want to stock up, or maybe you just plan on drinking more of it.
So for a normal good, the equation is as simple as it gets. More money means you buy more of that product. This applies to all sorts of things, right? Like going out to eat more often, buying new clothes, or finally upgrading your phone. But here's where it gets interesting. What if having more money actually makes you buy less of something you used to buy all the time? This brings us to our second possibility, which is a little, well, it's a bit counterintuitive. This introduces us to the idea of an inferior good. Now, that name is kind of misleading. It has absolutely nothing to do with the product being low quality. It's all about how our demand for something changes when we can suddenly afford what we perceive to be better alternatives.
For instance, let's say your income jumps up to 7,000 shekels. All of a sudden, you're looking at that old coffee brand and thinking, you know what? I'm done with this. I want that premium coffee I've had my eye on.
So what happens? Your demand for that original coffee drops, probably to zero. You completely abandon it for the upgrade. That perfectly fine coffee has just become an inferior good in your own personal economy. Think about it like swapping out instant noodles for fresh pasta from a restaurant. You can really see the core difference laid out here. For a normal good, a raise means you buy more. For an inferior good, a raise means you buy less because you're moving on up. These are two totally opposite reactions to the exact same event, getting a boost in your income.
Okay, so we've seen demand go up and we've seen it go down. But there is a third option. What if, even with more money, your buying habits for certain things just don't change at all? This is what's known as a neutral good. It's basically any product where your demand stays stable, no matter if your income goes up or down. These are often our true basic necessities.
I mean, the logic here is just common sense, right? You're not going to change the quantity. You needed one container of salt last month, and you only need one this month, even with that nice raise. Doubling your salary doesn't suddenly make you want to eat twice as much salt. Your need for it is pretty much fixed.
So, when you put it all together, what we've just uncovered are the three fundamental categories that describe our behavior as consumers every single day. And understanding them isn't just for economists, it's how companies predict what we're going to do next. Let's just run through them one last time, nice and clear. You've got normal goods, where you buy more. You've got inferior goods, where you buy less because you upgrade. And you've got neutral goods, where your consumption stays exactly the same. And this is maybe the most crucial takeaway. These terms, normal, inferior, neutral, they are not judgments about the products, not at all. They are just simple labels that describe how our behavior changes when our financial situation changes. What's an inferior good for you might be a normal good for someone else.
So I'll leave you with this question to think about. What was the last inferior good that you left behind after getting a raise or a new job? Whatever your answer is, it reveals a fascinating little piece of your own personal economic journey.